Hello, welcome to back to Let's Play Mask of the Betrayer, where we are have had Marin wake up. We've ha found Marin waking up in a spirit barrow, is what it's been called to what told it's what we've been told it's called in Rashimi, in Rashomon. Rashimi are the people. Rashomon is the land. Rashomon, hundreds of miles away, maybe over 1,000 miles away from the Sword Coast. There is some sort of eldritch abomination living inside our body that eats spirits. I don't think Marin has figured that out yet. But, def. Oh dear. We have none of the items that we ended the last campaign with.
Sorry, mistress. I didn't mean to swear.
And we have.
Certainly.
Ooh. That's right, that robe.
Yes.
Use this robe.
Certainly. Yes.
This robe is +3 AC, +2 all saving throws. +8 concentration. That might actually be worth it. This gives you Shadow Shield and Spell Resistance 24. Yeah, that's pretty good
What do you
actually.
need?
Spell Resistance 24 is actually fairly decent at this level. It will be less so as we go on. Now, spirits no items, creatures no longer drop parts that you have to mulch into essences. They just come as essences. And the essences have different names than they used to. Okay, ugh. Mouse is still a touch sensitive. I thought I had fixed that. Potion of Greater Heroism and a miscellaneous small object which we have not identified yet.
Yes.
It is a nice
I will take the
object.
lead.
In bonus to saving throws and in, saving throws versus mind affecting +5, saving throws versus will +3. That will get her up to just about level with
Yes.
her. No, it's getting her past.
I will take the lead. Come this way.
If I give you this. Oh, yeah, that's significantly better saving throw, I
Certainly.
guess. Okay, well, +2, +2, +2. Now, I think this version of Marin is prior to beating the actual Knight of. King of Shadows. Did not actually face the King of Shadows. Because you don't get a chance to save or export immediately after facing the King of Shadows. So I had to do just immediately before. So she's missing some experience as well. Maybe she got level drained. Jeez, the Yumiskari Gall took a lot. This one must tell you that you are not welcome here in Ice Spirit. Their nature is that of drifting snow, wild and fickle. This one must also tell you to disturb nothing, or this one must kill you. This one is sorry. What is this place? Look at those trinkets on the ice, beads and baubles, scraps of bone. They're offerings left by the Rashimi for river spirits, and they wash down from above. This one must guard the sacred Rashimi offerings and let none disturb them. Such are the terms of this one's punishment. Punishment? For mischief, this one is bound to this place for 100 years. This one's freedom will come in 57 years when this one is destroyed or when this one is made to serve a master. Okay, who did this to you? Oku, lord of this place. This one awoke Oku from his slumber, and Oku's rage was most terrible. What else do you know about this Oku? This one remembers Oku as a great bear spirit, very powerful and very angry. What was that you said about a master? This one shall be bound to its master, go where she goes, for the remainder of this one's sentence. This one finds such servitude preferable to this place. So all I have to say is that I'm now your master and you'll come with me. You can't trust that creature. It's like every spirit, every god. It will use you for your reasons of its own. Command this one to serve you, and it shall be so. Okay? I'd rather not have to fight over this room, and if this was what needs to be done, so be it. I command you to serve me. You know anything else about these creatures, Sophia? They embody the wilderness. They're capricious, shifty, rarely friendly for long. Even the Rishimi don't trust them. I'd rather not have to fight over this room. I command you to serve. Orglash vanishes and you feel your pack become much cooler. We now have a vulnerability to fire. And a 100% immunity to cold. But we were talking about burnt offering. Sacred pouch. Yes. And a ring. Which we're going to get identified here.
Come this way.
Ring of the Frozen Falls.
Certainly.
What does the string of Ring of Strength give? Oh, that's it. Okay. If you have all of them, I think they give you. Ooh! Per day uses hypothermia and polar ray. This is quite nice. Cold immunity, 25% bonus. Not particularly useful considering I already have that from the Orgosh in my backpack. But the spells are useful. There's a way to control this with the keyboard, but it's kind of iffy. Much prefer to do it with the mouse. There is no music. But we do have an offering now. Okay. Come on, guys. Catch up. So, we could use the rod, see if that would work. We could smash the bones, see if that would work. Ancient bear skeleton looks fragile enough to be easily shattered by weapons or spells. Consequences, however, are less certain. Okay. There we go.
We're making progress toward the surface. It shouldn't be much farther. How are you faring? I trust your limbs are no longer numb.
It takes more than bleeding chest wounds and binding runes to slow. Last time I heard this much, an army of the Walking Dead was involved.
Paralyzing forces can render muscles sore for days, but the pain will subside in time. I'm more worried about that wound in your chest.
I made a lot of enemies in Neverwinter, though I don't know who would want to cut me open and not kill me.
Neverwinter? This country, Rashomon, is countless leagues east of the Sword Coast.
We've established that,
unless
yes.
You've lost months of your memory, you no doubt arrived here by means of magic. When we're free of this barrow, we can look for clues as to how you got here and why.
You knew I'd be here. You expect... Actually, this place is an interesting change of place. No keep to manage, no city, nope. No ancient beast of the Shadow Weave. She is a little bit snarky. No. She's very serious. She's not snarky at all. Very unusual swashbuckler. Hmm. And you expect me to believe that's all you know?
I was tasked with seeing you safely out of this barrow. Now, if you don't mind, let's keep moving.
Right, we'll keep moving, but we'll talk more about this later. Okay. Now, if you asked her, she would tell... If we came in here earlier and they had the discussion about this wall, she would talk... If we had already had the sacred pouch, she would have talked about how you want to put it in a naturally occurring offering type thing, or a bowl, like a stump of a tree or something. This, we have this offering bowl that is a naturally occurring bowl shape. So we're going to put it in there, and she would tell us you need to light it on fire. In fact... Oops, no, not that. That. This is a small leather pouch containing dried meat and herbs. The wood kindling included inside the pouch indicates it's meant to be burned as an offering. So we know you're supposed to burn it. As the pungent smoke fills the cave, the ceiling, the barrier sealing the tunnel crumbles away. The passage is now clear. Ta-da. The path is clear. I'm going to go ahead and save over the Orglosh thing too. Just so I don't accidentally load up myself, my version of Marin with all her gear from the past campaign. Okay. Oh, right. Wolverines. Okay. Keep going, keep going. That's one down. Oh, I now have stone skin. Interesting. Nice to having a buff, happy wizard. That's always nice. Okay. And up we go. Actually, something else you might learn about her is she has a capability to cast something rather amazing. It's, I believe the term is a, persistent spell. It makes a duration of 24 hours. And why that's amazing is you have to cast it at a level 6, a slot 6 levels higher than normal. But she has the haste spell, so she could make a 24-hour haste spell, which is an amazing thing. Nothing there. I probably should, next time we rest, have her memorize that. I only discovered it after I, she'll level up somewhere along here. And I was filling up her slots and I discovered persistent spells. I hadn't known what that feat was. Okay, keep going. Hey, you're immune to critical hits because you're some sort of spirit or undead thing. Hello. Hello. Like Now I need a power that lets me critical hit undead. Die, die, die! She has an impressive collection of buffs, and she likes passing them around. Considering she likes to pass around buffs, I'm prone not to alter her spellcasting behavior. Because buffs are pretty efficient. She still wastes a lot of spells. Okay, now comes time to test. You do have disarm trap. Yay. This is an ugly thing. You rolled a 1. There we go, success. Getting a good look at this thing is difficult. It was crafted of twigs and clay, though. So it kind of makes sense that it would be a little bit ugly. We now have an amulet. What is this? Natural armor. Ooh, we're up to 34 AC. That must be because of something that's on her. Damage reduction, saving throw, skill, persistent. AC is increased. What did you give us that increased our AC? Okay.
Come this way.
Oh, that's immunity to a lot of charm stuff.
What do you need?
I'll keep the natural armor, though. Okay, this is already emptied. Okay. Ooh, what's this? Is that a... That is not a cave. That's a... Oh, that's a mushroom, isn't it? Yeah, that's a mushroom. Let's see if I can minimize this a little bit. Around. Okay. Around this way. Oh, look. Wolverines. Ghost Wolverines. Whoa! One showed up behind us. Behind me. Go hit him, giant... Saiyan person. Examine. Incorporeal creature was once a wolverine in life. It died defending Roshman and rose as a Telthor, a spirit creature, to continue guarding the land. And yes, that was a rather pathetic squeaking sound that came from the spirit wolverine. The spirit wolverine gave a really pathetic little squeaking sound and vanished into nothing. Oh, wow. Fumble, success. I must have given it an attack of opportunity. You know, I have enough to get power attack. I wonder if I could get cleave and great cleave. In addition to the two weapon stuff. Okay, Kaji!
Yes.
You can't pick things up, but you can unlock stuff. Okay. Open lock was a success.
Certainly.
Armor, sapphire, and blue diamond. Okay.
Yes?
Identify that for me, please. Shroud of the Leopard.
What do you need?
What does this give you? Is this... this is... material... what material is this? It doesn't say. Greater Cat's Grace. Listen and spot. This is for rogues. Let's see what happens if I replace it. Oh. That is a little bit odd looking. But it is 2 better AC, at least with the spell currently I'm currently working with. That is very neat. Okay. And I'll maybe blend in with the surroundings this way. I thought that was a... I did not realize it was that kind of thing. I thought that was a... when I saw it before, I never put it on. Because I had the Neverwinter 9 tunic, which was, you know, all my gear was amazing from the previous campaign because of all the crafting I did. I never put it on. Never saw what it looked like. I thought it was some sort of chainmail. I guess it's some sort of hide or leather? No, it's light armor.
Yes.
There we go. Did that
Certainly.
Thing where the keyboard commands weren't working for some reason. Shroud of the Leopard. Shout, Shroud of the Lead. Okay, so... this is a far change from her jaunty hat and her Neverwinter 9 tunic. Anyway, talk to you later.